Surat was Mughal Empire's most important port city and is where the British gained its first foothold. Situated on the banks of Tapi River in the southern Gujarat, Surat is well known for its textile and diamond industry for past many decades.
Gobi Talao, the water reservoir, was constructed around 15th century by Malik Gobi, who was a leading merchant of Surat. It was constructed after the Chalukya style of architecture which flourished during the Solanki period.
Surat has emerged as a port of international importance on the map of the world trade, which invited lots of attacks. The city of Surat was burned by the Portuguese for 3 times in 15 years, following which the Ahmedabad King Sultan Mahmud Shah III was very much annoyed by the frequent destruction of Surat and ordered for building a very strong castle and entrusted the work to Safi Aga.
The building which is used at present as an office complex by SMC is one of the ancient monuments of Surat city and was built originally as a sarai or Muzaffar Khana or a traveler's inn. It was built during the period of Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan in the year 1644 AD and was popularly known as Mughal Sarai.
The Dutch as well as the Armenian cemeteries at Surat are situated in a locality known as Ghulam Falia near the main road leading to the Katargam gate. The Dutch tombs are of various sizes and shapes, but the one that excels all the rest in magnificence is the mausoleum of Baron Adrian van Reed, the director of the Dutch company in the Indies.
The English cemetery is situated outside the city wall near the Katargam gate, reminds the visitors eloquently of many a famous names in the historical narratives of the English factory at Surat, who were significant persons in the political history of the city.
JJ Training College, located in front of Surat Castle, was formerly an English school established in 1827 from the donation by Sayed Saurabhji Jamshedji Jijibai.
Andrews Library is the oldest library in Surat. It was established in 1850. It was named after Andrews, a retired magistrate, and co-established by Rao Bahadur Nagin Jhaveri, a wealthy pearl dealer who often contributed to the development of the city. This is a historical landmark of the city. The clock tower was erected in 1871 at the expenditure of Rs 14,000 by Khan Bahadur Buroji Hormuzi Fazer. The clock on the 80 meter high tower stands testimony to the excellent workmanship of the British timekeepers.
SMC had announced 2 years ago on World Heritage Day a heritage policy and also took a vow to protect the heritage buildings in the city, for which it set up a heritage cell. Under the heritage policy, 2,417 properties in Old City and 574 in Old Gamtal of Randher, which were 80 years old or more, were identified to be in the need for conservation. However, in 2 years, no initiative has been taken on the part of the government for the conservation of these buildings.
In 2 years, the government has only started working upon the reconstruction of Surat Castle and Gobi Talao, and other heritage properties are still in the deteriorated state. It is a shame on us Surtis, as even being the citizens of this city, we fail to protect our rich cultural heritage.